Weather is really fine, and it is the second day of T20. Should I speak more? Is audio fine, or should I?
3, 1, 2. This is toss time from the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. Game number 2 of Qatar T10 Cricket League. Thank you, Anu. This is toss time for... Thank you, Anu. This is toss time at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium of game number 2 of Qatar T10 Cricket League. And with me is match manager Mr. Aminul Islam. To his right is Mohammad Hafeez, the captain of Desert Riders. And to his right is, of course, Kamran Akmal, the captain of Swift Gallopers. And Hafeez is going to spin the coin. Tail is the call.
It is head.
It is head. So Hafeez wins the toss. Hafeez, what have you decided?
We will bowl first.
Ball first. Any particular thoughts about your decision?
Yeah, seems like a little bit moisture on the pitch, so we wanted to use the early conditions.
And you have Sohail Tanvir to exploit those conditions?
Yeah, definitely. And also, there are some new, like, obviously, I'm playing first time with them. I know, like, the coach told me, like, they are very good with their seam attack, so let's see, hope for the best.
All the best for the game, Hafeez.
Thanks a lot. Thanks.
Kamran, अगर आप टॉस जीते क्या आप भी बॉलिंग करना पसंद करते?
डेफिनेटली पहले बॉलिंग करता है, पहला मैच है और कंडीशन को रीड करते हैं, लेकिन टॉस हमारे हाथ में नहीं है, इंशाल्लाह कोशिश करेंगे अच्छा टोटल करने की।
आप T10 एक नया फॉर्मेट है क्रिकेट में, T20 से हमने क्रिकेट को और छोटा कर दिया है, कैसा लग रहा है फॉर्मेट?
देखिए T10 तो पहले खेले हुए हैं, तो एक नई चीज़ है क्रिकेट में, एक्सपेरिमेंट होते रहते हैं क्रिकेट की बेहतरी के लिए। एज अ प्रोफेशनल हर क्रिकेट को मेरे ख्याल से सीरियस लेना चाहिए, तो इंशाल्लाह कोशिश करेंगे अपनी टीम के लिए एक अच्छा स्कोरबोर्ड टोटल लगाएं और टीम को जितना फायदा हो सके और बॉलर्स के लिए उतना टोटल करके दें।
गो वेल कामरान।
थैंक यू वेरी मच।
सो दैट्स अ न्यूज फ्रॉम द सेंटर। मोहम्मद हफीज, डेजर्ट राइडर्स, टॉस एंड इलेक्टेड टू फील्ड फर्स्ट। Thank you, Anu. This is toss time at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium of game number 2. Thank you, Anu. This is toss time at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium of game number 2 of Qatar T10 Cricket League. And with me is match manager Mr. Amir Kamran Akmakwain.
We wanted to use definitely, and the coach told.
पहले बॉलिंग करती है इंशाल्लाह
क्रिकेट में
T10 तो पहले लिए अपनी टीम के फायदा हो सके।
Go well. Please, desert right, toss and elected to field first.
लाइव फ्रॉम दोहा कतर। जी हाँ, दोहा कतर में कल से धमाकेदार शुरुआत हो चुकी है Q10 सीरीज की और इस वक्त हम यहाँ हैं एशियन टाउन क्रिकेट स्टेडियम में। वेल, कल की इस धमाकेदार शुरुआत के बाद आज के मैच से एक्सपेक्टेशंस और भी ज्यादा बढ़ गई हैं और आज का ये इंटरेस्टिंग मैच होने वाला है डेजर्ट राइडर्स और स्विफ्ट गैलोपर्स के बीच में। और कुछ और इंटरेस्टिंग इन्फॉर्मेशन के लिए इस वक्त मेरे साथ हैं क्रिकेट एक्सपर्ट और हमारे कमेंटेटर मिस्टर श्रीकांत जी, वेलकम।
थैंक यू।
सो मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि T10 का मौसम ने बहुत दिल खोल के स्वागत किया है, बिकॉज़ ऑल ऑफ अ सडन देयर इज अ सडन चेंज और इट वाज रेनिंग सिंस मॉर्निंग। व्हाट डू यू थिंक?
वेल, आई थिंक दैट इज अ वेलकम रेन इन द डेजर्ट और उससे मौसम काफी अच्छा हो गया है, बहुत खुशगवार मौसम हो गया है। सो ऑब्वियसली आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग द प्लेयर्स टू एंजॉय That hectic action.
Oh my God, मौसम अच्छा हो गया, but मुझे ऐसा लगता है कहीं ना कहीं pitch के लिए challenges शायद थोड़े बहुत बढ़ गए होंगे. So what do you think? I think it's quick time to go and check the latest status of the pitch. So right now over to Mr. Sunil Taneja and let's see what is the pitch report.
Thank you so much, Anu. Welcome to the weather and pitch report. First of all, let's start. But there was more first game surface right out of. I was having so lousy. Utterly smashed, but going to get so hot, you are going to the cap. Feel for you.
Thank you so much, Sunil. And मुझे ऐसा लगता है सर, जैसा आपने कहा था, कहीं ना कहीं कंडीशन जो है वो प्लेयर्स के लिए थोड़ी सी स्ट्रगलिंग, थोड़ी सी चैलेंजिंग शायद हो जाएगी, पर आपको क्या लगता है कि जिस तरीके से मौसम बहुत अनप्रेडिक्टेबल है और आज बड़े बड़े नाम यू नो दे आर एक्सपेक्टेड कि आज के मैच में वो खेलेंगे, सो डू यू थिंक इस पूरे सिनेरियो से उनके गेम पर कुछ असर पड़ सकता है?
देखिए, गेम पर उतना असर नहीं पड़ेगा, लेकिन जो T10 का फॉर्मेट है, जो लिमिटेड टाइम है, उसका कितना वो फायदा उठा पाते हैं, थोड़ा सा समय जरूर लगेगा उनको अडेप्ट करने में। पहला मैच है सभी के लिए, तो शायद थोड़ा सा लो स्कोरिंग देखने को मिले आज।
ओके, लो स्कोरिंग के चांसेस हो सकते हैं और इसी के साथ इट्स टाइम टू गो फॉर टॉस। ओवर टू सुनील। गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, दिस इज अनु लाइव फ्रॉम दोहा कतर। और दोहा कतर के एशियन टाउन क्रिकेट स्टेडियम में कल से T10 की धमाकेदार शुरुआत हो चुकी है। जी हाँ, Q10 कतर T10 सीरीज का जिस तरीके से कल आगाज हुआ है, वहीं कहीं ना कहीं आज के मैच से एक्सपेक्टेशंस और भी ज्यादा बढ़ गई हैं। वेल, आज का मैच होने वाला है डेजर्ट राइडर्स और स्विफ्ट गैलोपर्स के बीच में, और क्या कुछ आज के मैच से हम एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं ये बताने के लिए इस वक्त मेरे साथ हमारे एक्सपर्ट और कमेंटेटर हैं रवि कांत सिंह। रवि, क्या लगता है आपको कि जिस तरीके से मौसम ने यहाँ एकदम मूड बदल दिया है, क्या वो भी T10 का वेलकम कर रहा है?
डेफिनेटली, आई थिंक इट्स अ वेरी वेरी वार्म वेलकम विद द स्प्रिंकलिंग ऑफ डेजर्ट रेन, दैट्स रियली मेड द एटमॉस्फेयर मच बेटर। काफी फ्रेशनेस आ गई है एयर में और प्लेयर्स के लिए कंडीशंस बहुत फेवरेबल हो जाएंगी क्योंकि इतनी हीट नहीं होगी आज ग्राउंड में।
एग्जैक्टली, हीट नहीं होगी, मगर कहीं ना कहीं जो बारिश होने का खतरा अभी भी बना हुआ है, बिकॉज चांसेस आर दैट इट माइट रेन अगेन, वो शायद थोड़ा सा चैलेंजिंग मैच को कर दे। लेकिन एनीवेज, फाइनली होने क्या वाला है, पिच की इस वक्त क्या कंडीशन है? आई थिंक दिस इज द टाइम दैट वी शुड गो टू सुनील एंड चेक द पिच स्टेटस।
Thank you so much, Anu. Welcome to the weather and pitch report. First of all, let's talk about the weather, because it has rained in some parts of Doha this evening. Not very heavy rain, but there was some drizzle. So the weather today is a bit cooler, more pleasant for the game of cricket. And now coming to the pitch. It's the same track that was used yesterday in the first game. And it looks like a very, very dry track, at least from the surface. There is fair amount of grass as well. It's dry from the surface, but there is moisture beneath it. I was having a quick word with Kamran Akmal a few moments back, and he was also, you know, a little surprised after having a look, because for batsmen, it's not going to be easy. I mean, of course, we remember Hussain Talat, who actually smashed a brilliant half ten yesterday. But if the bowlers, especially pace bowlers, pitch the ball in the right area, that is the good length, they are going to get some wickets. But if you pitch it short, you are going to get hammered. So I won't be surprised if the captains today win the toss and field first again. Back to you.
Okay, thank you so much, Sunil. Well, sir, आपको क्या लगता है कि जिस तरीके से सुनील बता रहे हैं कि पिच की जो कंडीशन है उससे जो T10 का फॉर्मेट है उसमें हम क्या और ज्यादा धमाका एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं?
नहीं, पिच में कोई बहुत ज्यादा फर्क आया नहीं है मौसम के कारण, क्योंकि पिच कवर्ड थी, इसलिए पिच पर तो कोई बारिश का असर नहीं पड़ा। लेकिन हाँ, आउटफील्ड पे जरूर असर पड़ा है। आउटफील्ड थोड़ी सी स्लो हो जाएगी क्योंकि अंडरग्राउंड कंडीशंस जो हैं वो थोड़ी सी मॉइस्ट रहेंगी, थोड़ी सॉफ्ट रहेंगी, तो बॉल उतना ज्यादा बाउंस करके भागेगी नहीं, तो इस कारण से स्कोर्स थोड़े से कम नहीं।
यस, शायद थोड़ा सा एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट हमारे प्लेयर्स को देना पड़ सकता है बाउंड्रीज के लिए। बट इसी के साथ इट्स टाइम फॉर टॉस, सो ओवर टू यू सुनील, लेट्स सी।
Thank you, Anu. This is toss time at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium of game number 2 of Qatar T10 Cricket League. And with me is match manager Mr. Aminul Islam. To his right is Mohammad Hafeez, the captain of Desert Riders. And to his right is, of course, Kamran Akmal, the captain of Swift Gallopers. And Hafeez is going to spin the coin.
Tail is the call. It is head.
It is head. So Hafeez wins the toss. Hafeez, what have you decided?
We will bowl first.
Ball first. Any particular thoughts about your decision?
Yeah, seems like a little bit moisture on the pitch, so we wanted to use the early conditions.
And you have Sohail Tanvir to exploit those conditions?
Yeah, definitely. And also, there are some new, like obviously I'm playing first time with them. I know, like the coach told me, like they are very good with their seam attack. So let's see, hope for the best.
All the best for the game, Hafeez.
Thanks a lot. Thanks.
Kamran, अगर आप टॉस जीते, क्या आप भी बॉलिंग करना पसंद करते?
डेफिनेटली पहले बॉलिंग करता, पहला मैच है और कंडीशन को रीड करते हैं, लेकिन टॉस हमारे हाथ में नहीं है, इंशाल्लाह कोशिश करेंगे अच्छा टोटल करने की।
आप T10 एक नया फॉर्मेट है क्रिकेट में, T20 से हमने क्रिकेट को और छोटा कर दिया है, कैसा लग रहा है फॉर्मेट?
देखिए, T10 तो पहले खेले हुए हैं, तो एक नई चीज है क्रिकेट में, एक्सपेरिमेंट होते रहते हैं क्रिकेट की बेहतरी के लिए। एज ए प्रोफेशनल हर क्रिकेट को मेरे ख्याल से सीरियस लेना चाहिए, तो इंशाल्लाह कोशिश करेंगे अपनी टीम के लिए एक अच्छा स्कोर बोर्ड टोटल लगाएं और टीम को जितना फायदा हो सके और बॉलर्स के लिए उतना टोटल करके दें।
गो वेल कामरान,
थैंक यू वेरी मच।
सो दैट्स द न्यूज़ फ्रॉम द सेंटर। मोहम्मद हफीज, डेजर्ट राइडर्स टॉस एंड इलेक्टेड टू फील्ड फर्स्ट।
So Desert Riders se toss jeeta hai and they decided to field. Ravi ji, quick reaction, was it expected?
I think very much expected, because abhi people are trying to get a feel of the T10, the tempo and the environment. So I think it was a very, very right decision.
Well, right decision. Well guys, with this it's time for a break and live action after the break.
Hello and welcome to the Qatar T10 Cricket League. We are at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium in Doha, Qatar. And the match number two of this league is going to be played between, of course, Desert Riders and Swift Gallopers. Let's have a look at their squad. Mohammad Hafeez is the captain of Desert Riders, the former Pakistan all-rounder. And another Pakistani, Kamran Akmal, is the captain and wicketkeeper of Swift Gallopers. In the commentary box with Ravi Kant Singh, I am Sunil Taneja. Welcome, Ravi.
Thank you, Sunil. And the action gets underway. This is the first delivery, and I think we have started off with a leg by, possibly. So, definitely, players will be a little wary after the rain. And power play in progress. And soon it'll be quite interesting to see if the players really go all out for it. They've seen what is required. Down the leg side, that should be the first runs of the match. Yes, the umpire Prasanna, originally from Tamil Nadu, Chennai, but settled in New Jersey. So that is one without loss. And Sunil, let's see how the players feel. Kamran Akmal at the non-striker's end. After that, he will really be hoping that he can get his straight shots going.
Zahir Ibrahim on strike, the local lad from Qatar. Good shot, that one. And that's the first six of the match. Off the mark in style, Zahir Ibrahim.
Well, you can't have a better start than that. And especially if it's T10 cricket, gets it nice and sweet onto the middle of the bat and just lets it go with the pace of the ball over the ropes for six runs. So that is a challenge now for the Swift Gallopers, because they will have to maintain a line. Bowling on the leg stump will not help.
Pressure straight away on the bowler, Malik. Pulled away this time. There is a fielder in the deep. At least a couple of runs will be taken. So good start, at least on the first three balls, Ravi.
Certainly a very good start there. And two runs off the play. But the man who returned that ball should be in action very soon. Very, very familiar face from international cricket. That's Sohail Tanveer. Had his very unique action, which earned him a fair bit of success.
You said had, so we'll have to wait and see if that action is still intact or he has changed something. But he was very happy when he had a look at the track. And this is good comeback, hitting the deck. Good line and length from Malik this time.
Pitching it just short of length and getting a good bounce from the pitch. That's the area the medium pacers need to target. The moment you bowl length, you can be tonked about, which is true for any kind of... And there's you have Sohail Tanveer fielding at deep fine leg, so could be in action very soon. The patrolling area for fast bowlers when they are taking a break. Deep fine leg or third man. Another good delivery onto the leg in middle. Single nonetheless. Kamran Akmal on strike. 10 without loss.
Welcome back. We're at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. Spectators are now moving in to the stadium because it's evening time, and evenings here in Doha are much cooler than the days. In fact, the day was not very hot today because it had rained earlier. Not very heavy rain, but it was a very pleasant drizzle. Ravi and I enjoyed that after lunch.
And there's Sohail Tanvir in action and immediately getting a bit of movement away from the right-hander. Had Ibrahim in a bit of trouble there.
Left arm seamer going across the right hander is the norm. Zahir Ibrahim it is on strike. Again trying to go across the right hander. Oh, this could be close, but umpire Prasanna says no. Close call there. Last thing that Gallopers would want is a run out of Kamran Akmal, their most experienced campaigner.
And we had a couple of direct hits yesterday, one in the each innings. Sohail Tanvir was the happy man, Ravi, before the toss. When I met him, he was having a look at the track and he was really raring to go. Have a look. Adnan this time doing a jaunty roads, but unsuccessfully.
I think the man was saved by about more than a meter. So one of the easy decisions for umpire Prasanna. Kamran Akmal finally off the mark now with that single. Sohail Tanvir keeping it very, very nice and straight, not giving any room for the batsman to try and take any risks. So it's Zahir Ibrahim back on strike, and this time Zahir Ibrahim tries to go straight, gets it inside edge. Oh, short fine leg, picks up and returns. Close one.
Good tight bowling from Sohail Tanvir in his first over, and he's such a humble person. When I met him before the match, he was saying, Paji, it's just a T10 cricket, just two overs. Batsmen are anyways going to swing their bats. And this was the run out chance, the direct hit, but the batsman was comfortably in by at least a foot. Mistimed, and there's a fielder under it. First wicket goes. Sohail Tanvir picks up his first. Unlucky 13 this time for Swift Gallopers.
Went up high into the night sky, but very, very well judged. Came under it, waited for the ball to come down, eyes glued to the ball. We'd seen quite a handful of catches go down on the inaugural day. But today, the first catch has been pouched and pouched safely. There you see the ball pouched very, very.
The new man is Enamul Haq, and he is off the mark in style. Goes for that fine leg glance. And Sohail Tanvir, before he celebrated that success, he was hit for a 4, 17 for 1.
Enamul Haq is the new batsman, 17 for one swift gallopers. Sohail Tanveer picking up a wicket in his first over, bringing all his experience to a book and keeping the ball nice and straight, Sunil. Now that is what experience does for you. You don't try too many things. Just got 12 deliveries to bowl and bowl clear. So Enamul Haq. And immediately we have a Aljay Lal Cheta of Oman, Indian origin, obviously. Left arm orthodox and nice and straight, a loud appeal. Umpire Prasanna says no, but that would have been very close, Sunil.
Umpire Prasanna was not present by this shout, definitely, Ravi. But good start by Ajay Lal Cheta. Let's have a look. That was not a bad shout, maybe. It was drifting down the leg side, but the batsman was on back foot.
And there he goes, takes the aerial route. Wet outfield, but still well carried over the ropes. So that's a boundary for Enamul Haq, another local lad. The second one. And let's hope he can do better than what Zahir Ibrahim did. Started off with a six, but didn't progress too far.
Just a confirmation, Enamul Haq's first boundary was given as a leg by, so he opened his account just now, but his team definitely got those four runs. Good comeback by the bowler. There's a long off at place, long off and long on to outside fielders, and this is the last over of the field restrictions.
Yes, just to bring you up to speed, in a 10-over contest, the first three overs the power plays where only two fielders are allowed outside the 30-yard circle. And as Ajay Lal Cheta of Oman. Time going high and nice. Long off. Can he get there? Well, he did. Good coverage there from Tanveer, the other Tanveer in the team. Local lad Tanveer.
Tanveer did his job in the previous over. Ajay Lal Cheta gave a bit of flight and he made some room for himself. Ball went to the long off fielder after one bounce. There's a fielder in the deep, but not in the catching position. It's Adnan. Nonetheless, a single for the batsman.
So this is the last delivery of the power play coming up. 25 for one swift gallopers. Wouldn't be too displeased with the progress so far. They've been trying to get the ball off the square. Not easily done because the bowling line has been pretty good. Down the leg side again, off the pad. And that's the over bowl. 25 for one after three overs swift gallopers.
Ibrahim. 25 for one swift gallopers after being put into bat. Mohammad Hafeez, the captain of Desert Riders, had won the toss and he decided to field first. And that's not a big surprise. Sohail Tanveer, no, he's giving ball to his partner Malik, who went for 10 runs in the first over of the innings.
Awais Malik it is, none for 10 in his opening over. So let's see if he can try and get back, give away the 10 runs in his opening over. Kamran Akmal having a good look. This is the sixth, the only sixth of the match, hit by Zahir Ibrahim off the bowling of Awais Malik. Right arm over.
not great timing on this occasion. There were two fielders in the deep. One deep square leg, one deep fine leg. So a single for Kamran Akmal.
Well, trying to go to the cow corner rather than straight, because straight field has got protection. He's got a long on there. So he knows Kamran Akmal can be a handful. You see the field spread out there. You see the long on giving company to our cameraman on the ground.
The square leg has been moved to deep mid-wicket now. Again, trying to do that slog sweep. This time, Enamul Haq.
Remember, the field is spread out now, so can have up to four men on the boundary. Well, cricket isn't that bad. Bring out a yawn.
If it's a long day, but cricket is the best way to end your day after a long, hectic day at work. Just enjoy the T10 cricket, the fireworks at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. You can watch it live in most parts of the world. Flicked away. There's a fielder at long leg. Will return the ball safely.
Well, two dot balls and then 15 runs off 10 balls, last 10 balls.
That's Mr. Yusuf Jiham Al Kuwari, the Honorable President of the Qatar Cricket Association. He has he's quite thoughtful. Also has a small screen in front of him for the replays and for the commentary also.
Well, definitely keeping a very, very close eye on the action. Oh, good delivery. Good delivery there, Awais. Surprised Enamul Haq. Pitched it just outside the off stump. Four deliveries gone, just three runs in this over so far. Malik would be pretty happy.
Especially after his first over, which went for 10 runs. And he has given only two runs from his account because one is leg by. So two more deliveries remaining in his quota. Awais Malik, the local guy from Qatar.
Be pretty happy with the product so far. This time trying to go on to the offside, but gets a thick inside edge. Still not timing the ball well, but that will not be a tough one for Malik. One more delivery to go in this over.
So the projection is 76 if they go with the current run rate. If they accelerate to 11 per over, they'll reach around 197 very precisely. Yesterday we saw a total of 83, which was chased very easily inside 8 overs.
Straight hit, but quick single taken. 4 overs bowled. Now 30 for 1, Swift Gallopers.
Six overs remaining in this innings. 30 for 1, Swift Gallopers. Kamran Akmal, their captain and wicketkeeper, came as an opener. He is batting at 11. Enamul Haq batting at 6. And the only man out is Zaheer Ibrahim. Caught Mujib bowled Suhail Tanveer. Hit a 6 in the first over itself.
4 extras, all 3 leg byes and 1 wide. Kamran Akmal on strike. 11 of the 8 deliveries he's faced.
Mohammad Ikram is the bowler and he is not happy with the start. Adnan misfields and it's a boundary to start his spell.
gave too much room outside the off stump, and Kamran Akmal, being the experienced international cricketer that he is, did not need a second invitation. Look at the placement, absolutely pinpoint perfect. The ball racing away to the boundary. So Kamran Akmal now decides to get going, which may not be the best news for swift gallopers. There you see, up in the air. Can the long on get there? Oh, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. That ball is 3 meters beyond the ropes. Second six, getting an applaud from the QCA president.
11th sixth of the tournament, second of the game, and first from Kamran Akmal. Not a bad ball, mind you, not a bad ball. But great timing from the Pakistan batsman. Freeing his arms. 10 runs off the first two balls, putting pressure straight away on the new bowler, Ikram. Full toss, and it's a maximum yet again. Back-to-back sixes for Kamran Akmal.
Well, he had a target to aim at. That's a full dozen sixes so far. Hit it nice and straight. There you see, full toss, deposited over the ropes, right in front of the side screen.
16 runs of the first three balls. Trying again for that big one. Missed timing this time, Kamran Akmal, but shouldn't be displeased. Already made this over good for his team. There you go. Ikram, 17 runs in his first four balls.
Well, at the halfway mark, we could be getting close to the half century. That's it. Very smartly played, but didn't take full advantage of the full toss. One more delivery to go in the fifth over. Inamul Haq would feel he's missed out on that one. Got a full toss. Projected score at the current run rate could be 97. So we could be in line for seeing our first three-figure total in the tournament so far. This is day two of the Qatar T10 League. Outside the off stump. Five overs gone. 47 for one. Swift gallopers.
Kamran Akmal, 28 not out of 12 balls. Went for two sixes and 1-4 in the last over. Improving his team's current run rate. They are 47 for one after five overs. Five more overs to go in this innings.
Inamul Haq has decided to change. He's taken the cap and removed the helmet. As Mohammad Hafiz gets ready with his off breaks. Mohammad Hafiz, the captain from Pakistan, so he'll have plenty to do. But the first delivery has been slogged towards the cow corner. Single is all that he'll get. Bringing a smile on the face of Kamran Akmal. Now let's see what he can do with the challenge.
Extremely experienced bowler against an extremely experienced batsman. Right now it's Inamul Haq. There's a fielder in the deep. Tanvir makes, he makes a mistake. This should have been taken. He ran really well, but dropped the ball this time.
Watching it under the night sky, judging it is not the easiest, so can't really be too harsh on Tanvir. Tried to come under it. The bowler will certainly feel aggrieved and he has reasons to. Down the leg side, called a wide. So that brings in the 50 for Swift Gallopers. There you see the drop catch once again. High in the night sky. Tanvir coming in, not judging it best. Was reaching out in the end. And this time a stumping. And that will be the end of Kamran Akmal. So his Pakistani teammate, Muhammad Hafiz, has got the better of Kamran Akmal. Man behind the wickets, and Swift Gallopers have dropped their second wicket in the sixth over. 50 for two. Kamran Akmal trying to go for him, but missed it completely.
The wicketkeeper from Sri Lanka makes no mistake. Quick reflexes from Imal. And third umpire, well, the leg umpire had nothing much to do. 29 is the score for Kamran Akmal. 50 for two, his team. So Ravinder Pal Singh is the new batsman, off the mark straight away. He's from Canada. No need to mention roots in Punjab. That's what I can guess easily.
Well, Singhs, Punjab, Canada,
Taneja, Singh, Ravi.
The connections are inevitable.
There's a fielder in the deep, Kamran, but he is only a spectator. Good boundary from Enamul Haq. Applauds from the VIP corner for Enamul Haq. Four fours and three sixes so far in the innings. Two hit back-to-back by Kamran Akmal. He will keep the strike, Enamul Haq. Good over, nonetheless, from Muhammad Hafiz. It's 56 for two.
Enamul Haq now taking charge along with Ravinder Pal Singh for Swift Gallopers. Incidentally, as we said, six overs gone. Now they've got to start throwing everything at the sink. And Enamul Haq
Mujib. Left arm spin for Desert Riders. Mujib Khan for Desert Riders in his first over. So spin from both ends.
Which is smart play, actually, because then the batsmen need to generate all the power. There you see, trying to generate power. Goes for a mighty hoik, misses it. Ravinder Pal Singh going with the long handle.
Down the track. That is six number four for Swift Gallopers. Ravinder Pal Singh shows that he is capable of those mighty ones.
Nice and straight from Ravindra Pal Singh, pleases the crowd a lot. Ravindra Pal Singh has made his intentions very clear. He's not going to hang around.
Made room this time. Uses that extra cover area, but there's a fielder in the deep, Himanshu Rathod.
Inamul Haq now will try and use his local challenge. And there's Ravindra Pal Singh going for the straight six into the side screen. Smartly played. Picks up a single and hands the strike back to Ravindra Pal. Looks like the stronger of the two lads. Last delivery coming up. 11 runs and over from here will get us to the three-figure mark. Quite possible. Remember, this is a 10-over game.
Catch.
Outside edge, doesn't carry. Sohail Tanvir taking his time, but not much damage done. 7 overs gone, 66 for 2.
A wicket each for Tanvir and Hafiz. Both have an over left. Each bowler can bowl a maximum of 2 overs. Projection again 90 plus, all thanks to that a big over where Kamran Akmal hit the bowler for 2 sixes and a 4.
Ajay Lalcheta with his second over. First over went for 8. Left arm spinner, but did have create some opportunities. This time high and mighty into the VIP stands. Whoa, that is some hit right into the second tier there. Six number 14 of the tournament, and remember we are only in day 2.
Second six for Ravindra Pal Singh. This time he swept the ball and the biggest six so far in the tournament, beyond any doubt. There's a fielder and a single taken after a six. A very good strategy from Ravindra.
Well, that's smart play, really. You don't need to be clobbering every ball, not trying to hit the leather off the ball. Lalcheta's got to keep it just a bit short. At the moment, is pitching it up, hoping to get some turn. But there is hardly any turn on the wicket. Placed away, will get an easy single. Inamul Haq playing a very patient game. Taking those singles and handing the strike back to the man who can really clear the boundary with ease.
And of course, Inamul Haq is almost 41 years, Ravi. 40 years and 300 plus days. Born in Sialkot, Pakistan, Punjab. He has been staying in Qatar for a while. So yeah, it's a good strategy from the experienced one. Just take a single, rotate the strike. Not timing this time really well, Ravindra Pal. Not happy with himself.
Glued to the action at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. Remember, it's day 2 of the Qatar T10 League. Spectators coming in for the 6:30 p.m. local start. Stepping out, but not timing it quite as he would have liked. Picks up another single. Last delivery coming up in over number 8. Good comeback by Ajay. 4 singles, which no captain would mind in T10 cricket.
Catch.
Flicks it. Short of the fielder. Another single. Eight overs gone. 77 for two. Swift gallopers.
So 12 deliveries remaining in this innings for Swift Gallopers, and the projected score is 96. Can they cross that and reach the three-figure mark for the first time in this tournament? This is Ravikant Singh, my senior partner.
And that's Sunil Taneja with that nice, lovely smile, enjoying the cricket action at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. Didn't connect. Throwing everything, including the kitchen sink behind that one, Ravindra Pal Singh. He's got the power. Can he get the timing? Muhammad Hafiz. Wily old fox there, down the leg side. Another wide.
He's bowling around the wicket, changing his angle for the right-handed batsman. And he knows Ravindra Pal is capable of those big shots. Connected this time, but did not time well. Was a tough one for Ajay Lal Cheta. They will come back for two. Appeal for run out, and umpire Prasanna goes upstairs.
I think that's a close one. Inamul Haq running hard for the second. Did he make his ground? Umpire Prasanna decided to go upstairs, and there we see the ball coming in. And oh, third umpire will not have too many problems judging this one. Bails have come off.
That's out. Not a very tough call to make for the third umpire. Swift Gallopers lose their third wicket. Ravindra Pal, the danger man, is gone. 79 for three. Swift Gallopers. Inamul Haq, in fact, goes. Beg your pardon. So Ravindra Pal is still on the crease. That's a good news. Some good news for Swift Gallopers. Still 10 balls to go, Ravi.
Well, Inam was disappointed. Run a ball, 16. 79 for three Swift Gallopers.
Ten balls remaining. Sadiq is the new batsman, but on strike is Ravindra Pal Singh. Hafiz appeals for a leg before. And two runs for Ravindra Pal meanwhile.
Ravindra Pal on strike. There you see the run out. Bails taken off before Inamul Haq could make his ground. Wily old fox, Hafiz, going outside the off stump this time. Ravindra Pal Singh misses out on that one.
It's good bowling from Hafiz, using all his experience in the death overs. Down the track, Ravindra Pal Singh. And well caught by Mujib. That is the wicket the Desert Riders wanted at this time. Two wickets down in the ninth over. The more importantly, the danger man is gone now.
Got it low on his bat, and full marks to Mujib. There is Singh, full toss, low on the bat. Couldn't get the power that he wanted, and Mujib judged that catch very well. So Ravindra Pal Singh gone over, quick fire, 21. Swift gallopers, 81 for 4.
Last ball of the ninth over. The new man in is Naveed. In fact, both the guys are newcomers now. Very successful over from Mohammad Hafeez. 81 for 4 Swift Gallopers. Kamran Akmal came as an opener, made quick fire 29. And after that, we saw some big hits from Ravindra Pal Singh, who made 21. So two newcomers on the crease for the last over of the innings, Naveed and Sadiq.
Well, they need to get more than 13. That's Jahan Azeb Naveed to get to the 3-4 figure mark, which was looking like a possibility. And Desert Riders have gone to their most experienced man, possibly the best choice they had, Sohail Tanveer. So Hafeez, wily old fox, that's why we call him. Now left arm round, not very successful in international cricket with his left arm round stuff. Just a single of the first delivery. If you can keep it down to under 10, try and keep it under 90.
That's quite possible. The ninth over changed all those projections. Over by Mohammad Hafeez, the captain himself, took two wickets, one run out, and one caught Ravindra Pal Singh. Otherwise, Swift Gallopers were looking quite all right.
Look like galloping away, and this time it is indeed galloping away for the boundary behind the wicketkeeper. Not very intended it to go, but doesn't matter. Still four.
Runs are welcome. Source does not matter, especially in the last over. Completely missed timing on that occasion, Sadiq, but he will not be displeased with that boundary. Two bounces over the ropes.
Straight one from Sohail Tanveer. The furniture disturbed. And that's wicket number 5 for Desert Riders. Straight and on bounce. Doesn't help too much. And Sadiq NM must return. Swift Gallopers have lost a wicket. More importantly, it's a dot ball in the final over. And the score gone just 4, 86 for 5, Swift Gallopers.
Zainuddin is the new batsman. Again, that ball keeping low this time. Very, very good bowling from Desert Riders in these slog overs, in the last overs.
Well, that's why you have a man like Sohail Tanvir there, keeping it very, very nice and straight, close to the stumps, not allowing the batsman any freedom whatsoever. Just four runs so far in this over. Five sixes and five fours in this innings. Run rate of nine. May not be enough, but then it also depends on how they bowl. Going outside the off stump to play a cheeky one. Over the ropes, gets four. Get past the 90 mark, 91. There you have Kamran Akmal in chat with Inamul Haq.
That's what they want. Boundaries in the last over. The fine leg fielder was in the circle and Naveed knew it. One ball remaining. So 97 is the maximum they can get. Of course, if there is no wide or no ball.
Well, there haven't been any no balls in the tournament so far. We didn't have any through the 17 plus overs that we had. Almost 10 today. And this one has been clipped away towards the offside. Will definitely not be a four. Batsman going for a second one. Will they make it? Yes, they do. Hard running. 10 overs bowled. 93 for 5 is what Swift Golfers will finish with. So a target of 94 for Desert Riders. Should be pleased with their efforts so far. Sunil?
Absolutely, Ravi. At one time, it was looking that Swift Gallopers will cross that 100-figure mark. But good bowling in the last two overs by two experienced campaigners, Mohammad Hafiz and Sohail Tanvir in particular, picked four wickets in the last two overs and restricted Desert Riders to 93, which is not a bad total, mind you, looking at the conditions, but a gettable one as well.
Well, definitely gettable, because if you can get the ball off the middle of the bat, it does fly very, very far. And we've seen some big sixes today, especially off the bat of Ravindra Pal Singh. But Swift Gallopers, I must say, will be feeling a bit low because they could not finish as strongly as they would have liked. And Desert Riders will be happy that they could keep them under 100. The three-figure mark definitely looked possible. There you have the scorecard. Kamran Akmal stumped by wicketkeeper of Mohammad Hafiz. He and Ravindra Pal falling in the same over to Mohammad Hafiz. That was a big turning point. Sohail Tanvir picking up two wickets. Those are the two Pakistan internationals among the wickets. Partnerships between Kamran Akmal and Inamul Haq, 37 being the best. Ravindra Pal Singh and Inam put on 29 of 18. Not much else to talk about among the partnerships.
94 is the target for Swift Gallopers. As far as bowling is concerned, all the wickets went to the Pakistani bowlers. Two for Sohail Tanvir, two for Mohammad Hafiz. Only went for 13 runs in his two overs. And Tanvir giving only 16. Of course, Malik started the bowling and gave only 14 runs in his quota of two overs. So all in all, a very disciplined bowling from Desert Riders.
The pitch at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium getting a fresh coat of paint. Desert Riders need 94 in their 10 overs. We'll be back shortly for the start of the chase. Welcome back to the Qatar T10 League, coming to you live from the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. And Swift Gallopers, batting, put into bat first by Desert Riders, have finished their innings at 93 for 5. Kamran Akmal, 29. 21 from Ravindra Pal Singh. Inamul Haq held sway with 16. 2 wickets each for Sohail Tanveer and Mohammad Hafeez. Yes, they are the real Sohail Tanveer and real Mohammad Hafeez, the Pakistani players. Hafeez, there you see the highlights. That was the first 6 of the game, and that really got things going. That was Ibrahim, Zahir Ibrahim.
But Sohail Tanveer made his team come back in the innings. Picked up 2 wickets, in fact. One in his each over, especially the surprised possession of Kamran Akmal. Kamran Akmal came as an opener and was looking very dangerous when he was sent to the pavilion.
A lofted shots were the order of the day, and they really got the innings going for Swift Gallopers. They're trying to take full advantage, but this is Mujeeb in this time. A misfield there, sliced away past the fielder Adnan into the fence. So Swift Gallopers taking full advantage of whatever became their way. Probably a little carried away, trying to get too much power in the shots. This one landing nice and fine from the bat of Kamran Akmal, getting a round of applause from the QCA president. Full toss this time again, taken full advantage of, hit straight into the side screen by Kamran Akmal. That's where the international experience comes in. And then the stumping, end of Kamran Akmal's cameo innings. And he went off for 29. The bowler, Mohammad Hafeez. Now that wicket really set the cat among the pigeons, because another 6 from Ravindra Pal Singh went into the VIP area, the longest 6, but Mohammad Hafeez was equal to the task. This one skied and very well taken by this one dropped by Ajay Lakhatia, and run out nonetheless, got rid of Inamul Haq, the man who was trying to hold the innings. Smart play there, turning it away. Desert Riders facing off Swift Gallopers. Remember, it's a double header tonight. Desert Riders coming out to bat, and then we'll have the remaining 2 teams also in action tonight. Night sky from Doha, Qatar, as we see Kamran Akmal not with the gloves on, so he's not behind the wickets. Batting side nowhere in sight, not in the dugout as yet. So there might be a delay in the start of this innings, because the batting side is still inside the dressing room, not in the dugout. Ravindra Pal Singh. And the 2 batsmen now finally walking out for Desert Riders. There they are.
So Mohammad Hafeez opening the innings with Adnan, who is from Qatar. And keeping the wickets for Swift Gallopers is not Kamran Akmal. It's in fact Ravindra Pal Singh, as far as I'm getting the info. But Mohammad Hafeez, who bowled really well, picked up that crucial wicket of Kamran Akmal in his last over, is going to open the innings, and it's a decent total, decent score put on the board by Swift Gallopers. So a good start from Mohammad Hafeez is very much expected by Desert Riders.
Well, neither Hafeez nor Kamran Akmal are natural openers, but it's nice to see the captains taking the responsibility of batting at the top so that they can get the maximum advantage. Mohammad Hafeez taking guard. That's Mohammad Hafeez, the captain for Desert Riders. Adnan Mirza at the non-striker's end. Zainuddin will get us underway bowling for the Swift Gallopers. Umpire Prasanna is signals play.
Good first ball from Zainuddin, the local lad from Qatar, against a very experienced Muhammad Hafiz, almost 40 years now, played 89 T20 games for Pakistan and scored 1,908 runs with an average of 24 and strike rate of 116, which is required today, at least that strike rate.
Don't have to allow too much room. Again, outside the off stump, and this is an appeal. Zainuddin looking at it very, very. We haven't seen much movement of the pitch, Sunil. But a play and a miss certainly gets the bowler very, very excited. This time not very far from the bat. There was a late movement there. There you see Zainuddin looking at the wicketkeeper, not the umpire of the appeal.
Good ball, that one from Zainuddin. The first ball slightly short of good length. Second one pitching up, getting that lateral movement. Good start by this local lad. Off the mark, Muhammad Hafiz with that mistimed shot. Will not be pleased with this one, Muhammad Hafiz.
But we'll certainly be pleased to get off the strike, because if you're not getting the ball onto the bat, the best thing to do is to get to the other end. That's exactly what Muhammad Hafiz has done. Two local men in conversation, Inamul Haq and Zainuddin. Adnan Mirza on strike, Zainuddin. Given away just one run in those three deliveries. So two balls went past the bat of Hafiz.
On strike is Adnan Mirza, facing the first ball of this tournament for himself. That one came in and goes for a boundary. Feeling very unlucky, bowler Zainuddin. He is bowling really well in the first over.
Well, he's got all the reasons to feel disappointed with that one. Had beaten Adnan Mirza, all ends up. Unfortunately for him, the ball took the inside edge and flew down to the fine leg boundary. No wonder they say it's a batsman's game. Crowd enjoying the action. There you see Adnan Mirza missing it, getting in thick inside edge, ball flying down to far boundary.
Outswing follows the inswinger. Great bowling from Zainuddin in the first over itself. Dot, dot, one, four, dot. That four also came from an inside edge. The ball came in.
Well, nothing has come off the middle of the bat, that's for sure. So Zainuddin can be pretty pleased with what he has sent down so far. May have given away five. Not many happy faces in that dugout, although the VIP area has got plenty of smiles going around.
Finally, a well-timed shot to end the over. Nine without loss after one. Desert Riders. 9 without loss after first over. He's playing three balls, not timing even a single one. Adnan got two boundaries, one from the inside edge and one from that mighty square cut. Our organizers in conversation. They're doing a great job organizing this inaugural Qatar T10 Cricket League here in Doha. Mughis Bajwa for Swift Gallopers for the second over. There's a fielder in the deep, but ball was a little away from the guy at mid-on.
Very tough to go back on these ones. The fielders take a start as the bowler starts running in, so your momentum is forwards. Then you got to stop, turn and go back. Tried to jump, didn't time his jump there, but Mughis certainly wouldn't be too pleased with that effort. There you see the effort. Again, not of the middle of the bat. And the leap, not really the best. Wide outside the off stump. And called a wide, quite rightly so. Just outside the indicating line.
Ravinder Pal Singh, the fielder on that occasion. So he has he kept the wickets in the first over. And now he is standing in the mid-on. Mohammad Hafeez off to a start which he did not expect. Not timing even a single delivery so far. Full length, use of the wrists, and that's a boundary number three for Adnan Mirza.
Started off with a streaky inside edge, but then he's got two rank off the middle of the bat, and both of them have raced to the boundary. So Adnan Mirza would be feeling pretty confident about his form. Man of Indian origin. There you see taking advantage of the slightly overpitched delivery, just clipping it past the short mid-wicket fielder.
Good cover drive. Not clearing the mid-off fielder though, but he'll be happy to rotate the strike after getting that boundary. The man on strike now, Hafeez. Ravi is yet to middle a single delivery.
Qatar is a football mad country, so locals are trying to figure out how this game goes on. Not very different from the American game of baseball, they would say.
Now, Ravi, thanks to a big Indian and Pakistan population here in Qatar. We were talking to a local lad last night, Ravi and me. So we're saying that cricket is now picking up really fast in this region, all thanks to the Indian and Pakistan population, which goes without saying is most fond of this game than soccer.
Well, they don't want to lose their roots. And there you see the VIP gallery, the president of the Qatar Cricket Association having a look at his phone, possibly checking his messages, but certainly glued to the action with a little TV screen right next to him. Checking out the telecast being streamed on the telephones as well.
Yes, we're going live on many. This small screen, there's a phone in his hand to check the scores. We're going live on internet also across the globe.
Sunil, this is the world of multimedia.
Absolutely.
So he's checking every media possible.
Live action, live streaming, live scores. And that's a live straight hit. One bounce over the ropes to end the over number two. Adnan gets his fourth boundary, 21 without loss. Desert Riders. Thank you.
There's how the chase is going about for Desert Riders. 17 and 3 for the openers. Mohammad Hafeez quite happy to play second fiddle. They've already got 21. So they started the innings with required 9.4. Sufyan Mahmood will join the action. Sohail Tanveer refreshing himself after bowling that very, very good last over of the innings. On strike, Mohammad Hafeez. Outside the off stump, played high in the air to the vacant point region. The ball will win the race. Oh, well, it will not. The player pulled it off. Zainuddin it is. Fast bowlers are not known to be throwing themselves around, but that's a great effort. Certainly saved two there, Zainuddin, with that effort.
Poor delivery. That was meant to be hit. But the guy who stole the limelight was not the batsman, but the fielder, Zainuddin.
The umpires might want to have a look at that one again. His foot was over the ropes. But this one has got absolutely no doubt. Absolutely no doubt about this one. Placed to perfection.
Hafeez will be breathing now more easily after those well-timed shots. 67 runs to win from 46 balls. The asking run rate coming down now, all thanks to that flying start by the two openers. And mind you, this is the last over of the power play.
Just four more deliveries to go. Desert Riders got their act quite well. Adnan batting on seven, Hafeez on strike, getting into the act now. After being a spectator through almost the whole of two overs, steps out and this time clips it, but not far enough, straight into the hands of In Amul Haq. So it is Qatar bowled, Qatar caught.
And a big wicket, Mohammad Hafeez, the captain of Desert Rider, goes back to the dugout, and his team is not too happy after that start. Short ball that was meant to be hit, but not timing it well. Mohammad Hafeez, easy catch for In Amul Haq. 27 for 1 after 2.3 overs. Mohammad Hafeez goes for 9. Three balls remaining in the power play. Mohammad Hafeez, the first man to get out just before the break. Tanveer is the new man in. Great bowling in his first over from Sufyan.
Certainly putting a lot of thought into it. That's Mohammad Tanveer, another local talent there. This is why he's here, because Mohammad Hafeez got one on the outside edge, and In Amul Haq not making any mistake. 41 years of age, but sadly not showing any of it.
Looks a bit like In Amul Haq. That's, yeah, there he is, Ravi. Doesn't he look like In Amul?
That beard definitely looks very, very similar.
Also the tummy. Sorry, Inzi bhai, we love you. The sweetest guy, one of the sweetest guys in the cricket.
Smartly played. That will also bring to an end the power play. So three overs gone. 29 for one. Desert Riders chasing 94.
Riders still need 65 runs of 42 balls after three overs. That is the power play. 29 for one, Desert Riders. That's not a bad start, Ravi. The current run rate and the required run rate are almost close to each other.
Well, definitely, Desert Riders keeping up with the pace despite the loss of their captain and most experienced batsman, Mohammad Hafeez. Bowling. In the hands of Gayan. Facing him will be the new man. That's Gayan Willemshanta, another Sri Lankan origin player. Outside the off stump. Missed it. Mohammad Tanveer would certainly be looking to make a mark. There you see the action being followed on the mobile phones as well, where the actions are being streamed live across the
three fielders on the leg side boundary for Gayan Vimalshanta. A long leg, a deep mid wicket, and a long on. And a deep square leg in place. Also a deep third man. Cutaway will not be a boundary because of the slow outfield. There is plenty of dew also. Dew was there even before the match.
That was Zainuddin in the action. Qatar Cricket Association chief, the man behind all the action here at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. Good hit, but taken by the just a single, so all that effort for just one run.
Was a risky shot. There was a fielder in the deep, Mugis Bajwa, in fact, the fast bowler himself. But all is well that ends well. That was Mugis Bajwa, the fast bowler. 31 for one after 3.1 overs, chasing a target of 94.
Had a bit of a problem with his boot. We saw some problems yesterday as well. Using half spikes are not the best idea. There you see the shoe coming off completely. Realizes it pretty late. Lost the sole of his shoe. That's a new one.
But the boot needs to be rebooted now. He will need a new pair. The sole is gone. But the soul of the game is still intact. It will be intact forever.
I'm sure he must be having in the spare pair inside his box.
He's the man behind all the action, the Honorable President of Qatar Cricket Association, Mr. Yusuf Jiham Al Kuwari. Very dedicated person as far as the cricket organizing is concerned. And the organizers have done a fantastic job. That's the Indian crowd. We haven't seen a pure Indian player so far. but we are expecting to see more than a couple.
Well, the next match certainly has got a bit of a star attraction because we've got Hashim Amla in action in the next one, which will feature Heat Stormers and the Falcon Hunters.
But they have seen at least two Indian commentators and the broadcast crew, if not the cricketers.
A fairly large turnout of expatriates from the South Asian region. India, Pakistan, Bangladesh. Hasn't had the best of relations with his Baba, it looks like.
The young Mahendra Singh Dhoni with beard. Very young and a lot of beard.
That's the next match, Falcon Hunters and Heat Stormers, which will also feature the likes of Hashim Amla. There you see people following all the action on their mobile phones as well. In thoughtful mood, possibly wondering. New pair of shoes, and we are ready to go and get underway.
Not yet. Everything happening here.
Yeah, bailed out again. Possibly wasn't very happy with the way the shoe fit. Hope he'll be third time lucky.
Gyan Vimal Shanta from Qatar. Still not happy with the shoes, the new pair he got. Takes time to... Oh, he's exchanging the shoes with Zaheer Ibrahim. Good to have a teammate whose shoe size is similar.
And possibly somebody handed him two left foot. Oh, they're going to change both. So he's... I thought he was unhappy with only one.
So we've seen two very unique things, Ravi. A sole getting apart from the rest of the shoe and then bowler exchanging shoes with his teammate. This is definitely the new form of cricket.
Players in the dugout pretty amused with all the happenings on field. But the spectators staying glued, waiting for the action. ...33 for 1. Remember, the target is 94. There you see Sohail Tanveer. Okay, third time lucky. Yes, he is. Gets it though. Is that out of his hand?
That's not less than an achievement, Ravi. After that, a break of at least 3 to 4 minutes, all thanks to those two pair of shoes, which Gyan Vimal Shanta did not like.
Well, the first one didn't like him. The second one he didn't like.
Thankfully, Zaheer Ibrahim came to his rescue. Mohammad Afi is not happy. He got out at 9. Started in a nervous fashion. Started the timing. Look at that timing. Brilliant boundary.
Fair applause there. Getting it clean off the bat in the right area to pick up 4 runs.
Smiles all around. Giving width this time, Gyan Vimala Shanta. And Atnan is in splendid form. Thank you very much, he says to the bowler.
I am definite that he has given... A thank you note standing outside his crease for Gyan, and this time not getting right of the middle of the bat, but will pick up a single nonetheless.
...56 runs required from here on in 37 balls. Ravi was looking at the sky. Ravi says he was looking at the scoreboard, but I'm sure he was looking at the sky, whether there are clouds or not. There are some clouds, of course. I cannot see stars.
Well, the stars are not visible because of the floodlights, but the moon is nice and bright.
I have a star with me called Ravikant Singh. And look at that. He is a star also. A boundary to end the over. That's 42 for one. Run rate is 10 plus right now for Desert Riders. 42 for one after four overs. 52 more needed in the remaining six overs. Looks like easily gettable, Ravi.
Well, funnier things have happened in cricket, so we don't say it's over till it's over. Action in the middle. Getting pretty hectic and... shirt number 9. That's Ravindra Pal Singh, it is. So, fifth over with the Ravindra Pal Singh. Had a good run with the bat. Now, let's see if he can do the same with the ball now. That was all the way from Punjab to Canada.
Chance for the umpire to free his arms. Not a good start from Ravindra in his bowling. Captain Kamran Akmal coming straight to have a word with his new bowler.
Adnan Mirza. 43 for one. This one short, picked off. And well caught, one-handed, literally, Bhuvnesh Bajwa it is, and what a catch, waited for it, not easy to judge when you're standing on the boundary line, but still plucked it off like fruit of an apple tree.
That's a big wicket. Adnan Mirza was hitting boundaries, not a great ball from Ravindra. But a great, great catch from Mughis Bajwa at the square leg boundary. The catch of the tournament so far. Well done, Mughis. Adnan Mirza goes for 23, 43 for two. Desert Riders.
Fifty-one to get off 35 deliveries. New man in is Lianage. Left-hander on strike. Oh, missed the first one. So Ravindra Pal Singh really getting into the thick of things now. Picked up a wicket thanks to that fantastic catch by Mughis Bajwa on the boundary. There you see that. Wonderful take. One-handed, but pouched it absolutely safely. Mughis Bajwa bowled one of his quota of two. So really in the thick of things is Ravindra Pal Singh. Just can't stay away, keep that man away from the action from the man from Punjab.
Originally from Punjab. And he's come back really well after bowling that first extra wide delivery. You know, Punjabis love everything extra, extra cheese in the burger, etc., etc.
Along with that, diet drink.
Yeah, because we are very health conscious. Yeah, the diet drinks. He should be happy. Kamran Akmal got both the openers. But 50 more required of 33 balls. Very, very good comeback from Ravindra Pal Singh.
I think the first delivery that he bowled, the ball got stuck in his hand. Possibly was expecting a little more moisture on the ball because there is a fair amount of dew. 50 more required of 32 balls. On strike, Mohammad Tanveer. Oh, that's a mighty hit. Gets him 4 runs. Very well played. Classical cover drive there from Mohammad Tanveer.
Spoiling some party for Ravindra Pal Singh, who was mighty pleased with his effort until this boundary. Came down the track a little bit. Extra cover boundary. This was. Wide called. Bit touch and go case this time, but umpire Prasanna had no doubts in his mind that this was wide.
So the delivery needs to be re-bowled. The kids won't mind another extension to the action. Turn around the corner, another easy single. That's over number 5, bowled. 50 comes up on the board for Desert Riders, 50 for 2. That's the match summary for Yusuf. Calipers put into bat, scored 93 for 5 in their allotted 10 overs. Desert Riders in reply are 50 for 2 in their 5. So going quite up to the challenge now in this Qatar T10 League at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. Alongside Sunil Taneja, Ravikant Singh, and another change in bowling. Sufyan, it is back into the action with his second over. Did have success in his first.
He got a big wicket of Mohammad Hafeez in the first over itself. Gave only 8 runs, Sufyan. So in the first 5 overs, Desert Riders made 50 runs. And they need 44 runs in the remaining 5 overs. But both the openers are back to pavilion. Mohammad Hafeez and his partner Adnan Mirza, who was going great guns. Sufyan Mahmood is from Muscat, Oman. Has played 3 T20 internationals and picked up just 1 international wicket with the average of 39.
Well, action looks pretty sorted, but not the line allowed the batsman free his arms and swung it away for another single. 42 required of 28. Will need a bit of hectic finish there from Desert Riders if they won the 2 points from this game.
Slower one this time. Mixing his pace, Sufyan.
And Sunil, let's not forget, it is a doubleheader tonight. So people quite eager to watch 2 games in the evening. Second one starts about 20 minutes after the first one.
Again a slower one, but a leg by is on offer. Direct hit was attempted by the bowler himself. The next game, as Ravi was talking about, is between Falcon Hunters and Heat Stormers.
Are we confirmed that we could see some of the Indian players in action? Sohail Tanvir, there you have it. Falcon Hunters versus Heat Stormers, and Heat could be featuring MS Mahendra Singh Dhoni of the Chennai Super Kings fame. This one is off the middle of the blade, but only as far as the deep square leg. Don't want to mess around with Bajwa. He's plucked one out of thin air. Glued to the action at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium.
It's a beautiful stadium in the industrial area, in the Asian Town area of Doha. The atmosphere is beautiful for the game of cricket. So another leg by to end over. Another direct hit misattempted. It's 56 for 2 after 6 overs. Score reminds me of my favorite dialogue. Ab tak 56 run ban chuke hain and 38 more required in 4 overs. Required run rate is 9.5.
Well, little wonder that the net run rate, the run rate hasn't been brought down, which brings me to the point that net run rate will be the deciding factor if the teams are tied at points in the league. This one is clobbered straight to the long on fielder. Just a single for all that effort. Still in action. Mohammad Tanvir it is. There you see the next man paired up. Looking pretty eager. Although his team wouldn't want him in the middle just yet. So far, these two seem to be going quite okay. Wide call. ...58 for 2. Ravindra Pal Singh didn't bowl that badly, but again, trying too many things possibly.
5 wides given, Ravi, so far by the calipers. Short ball dispatched to the stands for a maximum.
Tanvir seemed to be expecting that one. Seemed to be ready. Possibly realized that Ravindra Pal Singh had intended to pitch it short. Almost a half tracker there. Deposited beyond the ropes. 6 runs.
9.5 is the asking run rate, and they have got 7 runs of 2 balls, one of a wide, and then a 6. Tanvir batting on 22, in there, in the gap as well. At least a couple is on the offer. A good over so far for Desert Riders. They have got 9 runs of first 3 balls.
66 for 2. 28 of 21, that's what the requirement. And we've got 21 deliveries, which may not make it easy to defend. This is a dot ball, rare. Desert Riders not really getting that momentum that they had hoped, despite a good start given to them by Adnan Mirza.
What a shot, straight down the ground. That's a Tufani shot. Two sixes in one over for Tanveer. Jumps to 30 in 14 balls. What a player.
Impossible to set a field to those. Absolutely straight as an arrow into the side screen. And Tanveer takes full advantage of the delivery that was pitched up to him. Last delivery of this over. Last legal delivery, I should say.
16 runs already, Ravi, in this over. Very, very expensive one from Ravinder Pal.
Another easy single. Seven overs bowled, 73 for two, Desert Riders.
So 21 runs required to win in 18 balls. The asking rate down to 7 runs per over now for Desert Riders. Tanveer is the man to watch. 31 runs off just 15 balls, Ravi. Adnan Mirza gave them a good start. And then Tanveer, look at that.
Well, nothing much separates the blue line from the pink. Still following that line, just trying to get over it. But that little dip between 8 to 10 overs, that's where the Desert Riders could cash in. And Inamul Haq it is, who is setting the field. So looks like he is taking the responsibility on himself for swift gallopers. Did a fairly good job as a batsman. Inamul Haq came in at the fall of Zahir Ibrahim's wicket, number 3, scored 16 runs. The local lad, 41 years old, now will turn his arm over.
Straight down the ground. The fielder is only a spectator. So Tanveer is the man in action once again.
That was an invitation. And Tanveer likes those. Such kind of invites.
Like us, we like the invite to call this event in Doha.
Well, certainly, very, very pleasant experience so far. We are only in day 2 and this time it slips, but whoa! How did he do that one? Lost his footing, but still managed to get enough onto the ball to make it sail over the ropes to pick up another 6. Slips. And there you see the ball not slipping at all.
10 runs to welcome Inamul Haq in bowling from Tanveer. Doing exactly what Talat did yesterday. Making this chase look so easy, so easy. 10 required of 15 deliveries now.
But the big question would be, can he become the second man after Talat? There you see that slip. The left foot went first. Again, those half spikes that we keep talking about. The culprit not giving him firm enough footing. Now, does he have enough to get to that 50 mark? Just 10 required for a victory. Balls don't matter. Good decision not to go for the single.
For the first time, the asking run rate is below 6. After that, a 4 and a 6 from Mohammad Tanveer, the hero of this match. Down the track. Oh, clean ball. Something to smile for in this over for Inamul Haq.
Bowled it very, very straight. I hit if you miss. And that's exactly what happened Emalian again jumping out, the left hander missing it completely, and the ball clipping the off stump. So that is the end of innings for Emalian again. Gone for three, 84 for three, Desert Riders.
Last ball of the eighth over. New man in Sohail Tanveer. So two Tanveers on the pitch now. Eight overs gone. 85 for three. Balls remaining, nine more runs required to win for Desert Riders. And Amul Haq got a wicket in his first over, but before that he was hammered by Mohammad Tanveer. That's a wicket we were talking about.
That was success for Enamul Haq, as he bowled his only over so far. Nine more to get, and you see the Tanveer and Tanveer duo there, Tanveer Junior and Tanveer Senior. That's Sohail Tanveer, the left-hander, Mohammad Tanveer, the right-hander, batting on 43 of just 18. 42, beg your pardon. 42 of 18. And Sohail Tanveer, we'll refer to Sohail Tanveer as Tanveer Senior because of his international experience.
He was a star in bowling. Two overs, 16 runs, two wickets for Sohail Tanveer. Right now on strike. And Mohammad Tanveer, the star in batting. 42 runs of 18 deliveries. Sohail Tanveer rotating the strike, and very rightly so.
Okay, now this is a big one for Tanveer, Mohammad Tanveer, I would say, Tanveer Junior. Can he get it all together? Two boundaries. Zainuddin, the bowler, needs two boundaries to get to his 50, needs two boundaries to complete victory for his side. Hafiz deep in conversation with his teammates. Knows he's made the right calls today to pick up those 2 points from this game.
Good bowling from Zainuddin. This is his second over.
Bit of a chat between Tanveer and Tanveer. Mohammad Tanveer on strike. 42 of 19. That's the yield for him so far. Eight required as he faces up to Zainuddin.
Goes for a big one. And it is a big one. Maximum once again for Mohammad Tanveer.
Possibly got the right advice to get six number 18 of the tournament. Mohammad Tanveer must have been told by his partner, you don't worry, go for your shots. The 50 is there for taking. And getting a 50 in this kind of a competition is like getting a century in 20 over cricket. Remember, each innings is a maximum of 60 deliveries, legal deliveries. Another one. Down and put down.
Catch dropped by the long on fielder. The score is tied now and Riders need one run off eight balls. And on strike is Sohail Tanveer. Will he just defend the two balls?
I wouldn't be surprised if he does. To let his partner get those that coveted half century. There you see the second one. Just short of the ropes. Long on fielder gets underneath it and floored it. Eyes still blinking. Possibly lost it in the light towers, but Sohail Tanveer wants to finish it off, doesn't want to leave it to the last over. And the ball creeps, stops, but the batsmen have already run across. So that with it, 49 not out is what Muhammad Tanveer got it. And so Sohail Tanveer finishing it off. As Desert Riders reached 94 for 3 and Riders won by 7 wickets. Wonderful performance by Muhammad Tanveer. Sunil?
Of course, the president of QCA could not be happier. Match number 2 also won by the chasing team in the 9th over. Yesterday we saw a half century from Talat and today Tanveer felt short of his half century by just one run, but nonetheless, a great, great innings from the youngster. And Riders won by 7 wickets, defeated Swift Gallopers in style.
Handshakes all around, and it has been a good performance there. There you see the Hafiz 9 went early, but Adnan did well to get 23, and Tanveer. Muhammad Tanveer, that is 49 not out, unlucky to miss out on his half century. 49 of 21 certainly makes him a very, very strong contender for the man of the match award, sir. And Zainuddin, it is did start it off well, but couldn't really get things under control. Ravinder Pal Singh picked up one wicket for Inamul Haq as well, but in the end it was not good enough. So that's how it all ended. Desert Riders winning the match by 7 wickets thanks to that 49 unbeaten knock by Muhammad Tanveer and picking up 2 points to go level with Flying Oryx, who had won the match by 9 wickets against Pearl Gladiators. But you don't go anywhere. We'll take a short break and we will be back with the presentation for this game.
Hafiz Tanveer, fir kaam.